hear the next explanation from proper adjective. So what is proper adjective? Do you know what is proper noun? Proper noun means it's the name of a place, name of a person. These things are called proper noun. A proper adjective means those adjectives which we take from proper noun. India is a proper noun. So from India we get Indian. So that's why it is proper adjective. Again from China we get Chinese is proper adjective. And from Italy we get Italian. So these are the proper adjective we get from proper noun. So you understand this? In my example I have given here, Ram is an Indian boy. So this Indian is an adjective. It modifies or qualifies the noun boy here in this sentence. As it qualifies it, so it is an adjective. That's why it is proper, because it comes from proper noun. In the second example, Peter was an Italian leader. So here in this sentence, you see, Italian qualifies the noun leader here in this sentence. So it is proper adjective. It comes from the noun, proper noun, Italy. That's why it is proper adjective here. So it is proper adjective, but in our book, it is not given. Many books it is not given, but when you get this word in a book or in an exercise, how can you explain this? So for this, I have written here, you have to learn this, what is proper adjective. Okay, thank you. Next category is emphasizing adjective. It's number 9. Is emphasizing adjective. It is number 9. We know emphasizing pronoun, but there is no connectivity with emphasizing adjective and emphasizing pronoun. Emphasizing pronoun. So here you see examples are on, very. Only two examples are there for emphasizing adjective. How you can use this in the sentence? Number A, that is my own book. Have the word own, emphasize on the book that you specially tell that this book is yours. That's why it is emphasizing adjective. So it qualifies the noun, the book. Again, the very person I met there was a scholar. The very person I met there was a scholar. So here, see, the word very qualifies the noun person here. That's why it is emphasizing adjective, because it emphasizes the person here in this line. This way, emphasizing adjectives can be described, but I think it is not given in many books. So you have to understand this. This is the 9th time it is emphasizing adjective. So I am going to explain the last one. It is relative adjective. Number 10 and the last, the relative adjective. So, what is relative adjective? The relative adjective is the adjective that introduces relative clause like relative pronoun. How you see, what, which, that, like this. These are the examples of relative adjective. How can you use in the sentence? I know what book did you one. See, here the relative adjective qualifies another noun, it is book. That's why it is relative adjective. Okay, this way you can explain all 10 kinds of adjectives in your copy book. You have found in your grammar book. You have to go through the examples given in the book also. You will do the exercise, then you will understand what is the adjective and what is the classification, explanation about the definition of. Okay, thank you. All the best, students.